you might be able to work out what that has in common with these other things. A slingshot, a bouncy ball, and the alarm clock. Can you work it out? Let's find out. You've probably seen one of these before, whether it's at a $2 shop, maybe at an arcade. You may have even found one in a show bag at the Royal Show. Now, they're pretty awesome. Not quite as flashy as Hot Wheels, or not quite as techy as a remote control car, but they're still pretty fun, even for adults like me. And the best thing about these is that they don't need batteries. They just go. Ooh, that was cool. Hit a wall and came back. So the pullback car was invented about 70 years ago by a guy called Fred Francis. He wasn't too good at school, but he loved inventing stuff. After inventing the pullback car, Fred went on to invent scalectrics, which is really awesome. We don't have one of those here at SciTech, but I would absolutely love to pull one of those apart. So there's a couple of ways that you can move this car. You can push it forward, pretty cool. You can pull it backwards, but as you pull it back, it starts to get a little bit of resistance, unless you push down. Pushing down is where the magic happens. Is it magic? It's not magic, it's science.
So let's have a look inside and see what's actually making this car move, and why do we have to push it down and pull it back for it to go forward? Only one way to find out. Let's tear this toy down. We're actually going to be pulling this toy apart, and it's likely to break. So make sure that you've got an adult around, and also make sure that you've got no little brothers and sisters around, because there's lots and lots of little pieces in here that might be a choking hazard. And we might entirely break this toy. So if you really, really love your pullback car, maybe don't pull it apart. Make sure you've got an adult with you. Let's do this. I'm going to start by pulling this chassis off, and I think I can just use my nails for that. So don't need any particular tools, as far as I know. Oh, that came apart way quicker than I thought. I have completely snapped the entire chassis off the car. That's okay. We can still pull it apart and figure out how it's working. So this is the exterior shell. It kind of opens like a cool, it looks like one of those superhero cars right now. I'm gonna leave that to one side. There's just the wheels attached there. This is the part we're interested in. Wondering if it still works. Let's see. Let's try and pull it back. Whoa! It does still work, which is awesome. Who thought you needed four wheels of a car? So it looks like this can be popped open in two halves. So there's a two kind of shells, two halves of a shell here that can just be pulled outwards. I think first, before I do that, I'm gonna remove one of the wheels so we can see the inside a little bit better. So, try and pull this one off. Sometimes they come straight off, but it looks like this is actually being hot glued in. Come on. Ah, there we go. Let's try and prop this open. You can see there's lots of little parts inside there, so I'm going to try and keep it on this side so that these things don't fling out everywhere, all over the place, because that's often what happens. But I have to be really gentle. Yes! Aww. Okay. So, let me go and collect these things that fell out. So we've got some little gears or cogs inside. Pull this side off. Right. Okay, so now that we've managed to take away the shell and all of our gears have fallen out everywhere, except this one, we can have a look a little bit further, and I pulled this one off. Ah! You can see inside, there's what looks like this metal coiled around the inside. So if I have a look at this gear, I can see that there's a groove on the end of it there, and that went straight into this metal coil. You're starting to have a bit of an idea as to how this works. So let's have a look at this metal coil a little bit closer. This is how long it is. It's very, very tightly wound inside the casing of the pullback car with this attached to it. And as I pulled it out, it completely sprung out of place, and my guess is it's going to be very, very tricky to put back in, so I'm not going to try that. But this gives us a bit of an idea as to how this pullback car works, which is elastic potential energy. So what is elastic potential energy? I've got some props to show you. So anything that is an elastic material that is stretched or compressed, twisted, can possess elastic potential energy. When I stretch this further, the more potential energy is building up, and as I release it, it turns into movement or kinetic energy. So let's have a look at our coil again, which is quite messed up now. I'm going to get something a little bit bigger to explain elastic potential energy. Good old cable tie. I've said this before, but the front bumper of my car was literally once held on by a cable tie. So this cable tie isn't as stretchy as the elastic band we just had, but it still possesses elastic potential energy properties. So if I grab this plier here and wind this around and around, what is going to happen when I let go? It's going to spring back to its almost original shape. And that's essentially the principle of this car.
You can see that the coil is very, very tightly wound around the inside of the casing of this car, but that still doesn't explain how the car actually moves. So for that, I'm going to bring in some bigger props to explain. Cogs, big cogs, or gears as they're known inside motors. So inside our car is a range of different cogs or gears. They all interlock in various ways. Imagine this wheel here is the wheel, and as I pull the wheel back, the cogs turn. But this is also attached to our coil or spring, which is wound tightly around. As I pull the wheels back, it starts to wind our spring even more and more and more, and that's gathering more elastic potential energy. Then, as you let go of the car, all of that elastic potential energy is released, the car propels forward, and there you have it. Cogs are super interesting. We could go into an entire video on how they work. Maybe we'll do that in the future, but there's actually a really good YouTube video from Jared Owen that you can check out to learn more about cogs or gears. We'll chuck that link in the description, so definitely check that out. So this toy, which has managed to change color all of a sudden, is awesome because it completely relies on the buildup and release of elastic potential energy. Can you think of some other things that use elastic potential energy? There's bow and arrows, maybe a diving board, trampolines, prosthetic legs or blades. You've got slingshots, even a sponge. All of these things use elastic potential energy to create motion. So today's toy teardown was really interesting to me because this is a really, really simple toy. Well, it seems to be. You can find them everywhere, they're cheap as chips, but it's quite complex. And the science inside on how it all works was quite interesting. I hope you learned something. I certainly did. A little bit, at least, about elastic potential energy and how it works. But that's not the only kind of potential energy out there. Potential energy doesn't only exist in elastic stuff. In fact, there's lots of different kinds of potential energy. For instance, this Newton's cradle. As I hold this ball up here, it's got potential energy. and then I let it go, turning it into kinetic energy. Even that plant currently has potential energy. Or if I was to hold this Newton's cradle here and almost about to let it go, that would be a different kind of potential energy, which would be gravitational potential energy. Even this duck has potential energy. I'm about to introduce it to my friend over here, the slingshot. I hope you guys have enjoyed Toya Teardown today. It's been an absolute pleasure tearing down this pullback toy. I hope you guys can maybe harness your own elastic potential energy. Maybe you can make your own slingshot or something like that. Until then, like, subscribe, comment. We'd love to hear what you thought about the show. And we'll see you next time. This has been Toy Teardown.